Today I will be reviewing the Luxebell, Gopole and monopod. Before I go into the specs, I will tell you that you can use this on other cameras because it comes with this awesome adapter. It has the GoPro teeth on one end and a tripod on the other. So you can put this onto the inbuilt GoPro mount and you can have any camera you want on this, which is great. It is made of hard anodized aluminium with a foam hand grip on the bottom. It also has a tripod mount in the base of it, so you can put this onto a tripod or any sort of mount, which is really cool. And it comes with a branded wrist strap. You should always use this. It's also the kind that has a lock on it, which I absolutely love. You can tighten it to any wrist size, which is great for me since I have ridiculously tiny wrists. Here's a can of juice, and that's how small my wrists are. It's ridiculous. Like I said, this is extendable. It is in the smallest size right now, which is 12 inches, but it extends to 40.5 inches. All you need to do is turn the top of it to the right, and it'll go all the way around, and then it extends. It's in three sections when it is extended, and that's really good. So to make it fit in the screen, I'll take it smaller. And then once you got it to the size you want, just turn it to the left, and that's it. So you can have it any size, any length you want, which I think is great. I love this feature because on other monopods and GoPoles, they lock in certain positions. So if you want it a specific length, you might not be able to get it like that. I think this is waterproof, but since it is aluminium, I don't think it would float. So if you're going to be using it around water, always have the wrist strap on. I have terrible grip, but I can hold on to foam really well, so this is the perfect grip for me. I think anybody would be able to get a really strong grip on this with ease. And since it's foam, if your hands are sweating, it won't slide because the moisture will be taken away into the foam and it won't be slidey at all. It costs £10 on Amazon, and I think it's really worth it.